Welcome. We're so glad you came to share this Mass with us. Our opening song is number 207 in your Missalette, 207 in the Missalette. Praise to the Lord.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
On us, for you alone are the holy.
You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace on earth, peace to people of good will. Let us pray. Show favor, O Lord, to your servants, and mercifully increase the gifts of your grace, that made fervent in hope, faith, and charity, they may be ever watchful in keeping your commands. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Book of Wisdom. There is no God besides you who have called on the care of all, that you need to show that you have not unjustly condemned, for your might is the source of justice. Your mastery over all things makes you lenient to all. For you show your might when the perfection of your power is disbelieved, and in those who know you, you rebuke temerity. But though you are master of might, you judge with clemency, and with much lenience you govern us. For power, whenever you will, attends you. And you taught your people by these deeds that those who are just must be kind. And you gave your children good ground for hope, that you would permit repentance for their sins. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The sound of my pleading.
Lord, you are good and forgiving.
All the nations you have made shall come and worship you, O Lord, and glorify your name. For you are great, and you do wondrous deeds. You alone are God.
Lord, you are good and forgiving.
Slow to anger, abounding in kindness and fidelity. turn toward me and have pity on me. Give your strength to your servant.
Lord, you are good and forgiving.
The second reading is a reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, the Spirit comes to the aid of our weakness, for we do not know how to pray as we ought. But the Spirit himself intercedes with inexpressible groanings, and the one who searches hearts knows what is the intention of the Spirit, because he intercedes for the holy ones according to God's will. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. May the Lord be in your heart and on your lips, that you might proclaim his gospel worthy and well. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
Alleluia.
Blessed are you, Father, Lord of heaven and earth. You have revealed to the little ones the mysteries of the kingdom.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus proposed another parable to the crowd, saying, "The kingdom of heaven may be likened to a man who sowed good seed in his field. While everyone was asleep, his enemy came and sowed weeds all through the wheat and then went off. When the crop grew and bore fruit, the weeds appeared as well. The slaves of the householder came to him and said, 'Master, did you not sow good seed in your field? Where have the weeds come from?' He answered, 'An enemy has done this.' His slaves said to him, 'Do you want us to go and pull them up?' He replied, 'No. If you pull up the weeds, you might uproot the wheat along with them. Let them grow together until harvest. Then at harvest time, I will say to the harvesters, first collect the weeds and tie them in bundles for burning, but gather the wheat into my barn.' He proposed another parable to them. 'The kingdom of heaven is like a mustard seed that a person took and sowed in a field. It is the smallest of all the seeds, yet when full grown, it is the largest of plants. It becomes a large bush, and the birds of the sky come and dwell in its branches.' He spoke to them another parable. 'The kingdom of heaven is like yeast that a woman took and mixed with 3 measures of wheat flour, until the whole batch was leavened.' All these things Jesus spoke to the crowds in parables. He spoke to them only in parables, to fulfill what had been said through the prophet, 'I will open my mouth in parables. I will announce what is lain hidden from the foundation of the world.' Then, dismissing the crowds, he went into the house. His disciples approached him and said, 'Explain to us the parable of the weeds in the field.' He said in reply, 'He who sows good seed is the Son of Man, and the field is the world. The good seed, the children of the kingdom. The weeds are the children of the evil one, and the enemy who sows them is the devil. The harvest is the end of the age, and the harvesters are angels. Just as weeds are collected and burned up with fire, so will it be at the end of the age. The Son of Man will send his angels, and they will collect out of his kingdom all who cause others to sin and all evildoers. They will throw them into the fiery furnace, where there will be wailing and grinding of teeth. Then the righteous will shine like the sun in the kingdom of their Father. Whoever has ears ought to hear. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
In our Gospel, we have many, many parables today, and it's helpful to look at them from different points of view, from different perspectives. And so looking from a broader view at the first parable with the weeds and the wheat, it's really talking about eschatology, which is a big fancy word for the four last things: judgment, heaven, hell, and purgatory. So that's essentially what it's about. And a helpful way to look at it is to look at it as like an orchard. Like you're cultivating apples and you are wanting to grow some Honey Crisps, some Granny Smiths, some Golden Delicious. Like, you know what they should taste like, you know what they should look like, you know what the end result should be for these fruits. And so you're cultivating them, and some of them are exactly what you're looking for. They're the ideal fruit, they're perfect in how they are. And so that's kind of like heaven, like those that are ready to go to heaven. They go into the barn and are ready. And then there are apples that aren't quite ready yet, ones that maybe should stay a little longer, need to ripen more. And so you need to gas them or give them a little care, or maybe they have some blemishes that need taken care of. And that's basically what purgatory is like. We're not yet ready and perfect for heaven to meet God face to face. And so we're formed, and those blemishes and things are purified and wiped away. But then these apples sometimes you get that are just rotten and totally good for nothing. You just throw out behind the barn. That's essentially what hell is for those who have chosen to not, for those who have just become so corrupt by sin. And the question really becomes then, why hell? Like, if God is all good, why would he send us to hell? And the fact is, we're made in God's image. And whenever we act contrary to that, we're turning away from God. We're basically choosing with our free will. We're not choosing love. Like, we're supposed to be images of God's love in the world. We're supposed to actually manifest him, his very person in the world, through how we live and how we love others. And failing to do that, choosing to turn in on ourselves to be selfish, we're acting contrary to who we actually are, contrary to God's very image. And so we're meant for so much more than that. And so the ideal, what God is inviting us to, is an eternity forever with him and sharing his blessed life. That's the goal. That's what heaven is all about. And it's also helpful to look at this parable from a more personal view of how it affects us with the weeds and the wheat. And so you can look at the field kind of as your heart or your soul. And the bad seed that is used in this parable is called cockle. And it's this plant that looks just like wheat. And you don't know it's not wheat until it starts to bear fruit. It looks almost exactly the same until then. And as a matter of fact, it's actually poisonous to humans. And so it was actually really important in that day to figure out what's wheat and what's not. Because you could die if you had too much of it. And that's sin, right? The enemy goes through and sows these seeds of poison to us. That's what sin is. It's poison. He gives us these half-truths and these lies, and sometimes we're not even aware of them. They seem almost kind of true, but they're not quite right. And you see this so much in our media today, and like these TV shows, and just in the world, and you see the effects of it. One example is a show called How I Met Your Mother. It's similar to Friends, in that there's a group of friends, and they're all, it's just a sitcom about their relationships, and essentially it glorifies and just tries to normalize the sins of like lust, licentiousness, betrayal, lying, and gossip. And it's terrible. Like, on the surface, it's funny. It really is. There are many funny moments. But then there are these seeds that are sown throughout it of, oh, it's okay to just sleep with your friends or to lie and betray those you love. And, like, all will be forgiven. It'll all be fine. But that's not true at all. Like, that's not how this works. It takes work and selfless love and friendship. And you have so many shows like this all over, everywhere, on TV, through Netflix and Disney+. There was even a kid show I was made aware of called The Owl House, and it just tries to normalize LGBT relationships and saying that, yeah, it's all good. And it's not, because we're made for so much more. God has so much more in store for us, and anything less than that is not good enough. And we need to realize that whose image we're made in. And the reason the enemy does this and sows these half-truths is he's trying to actually create us, trying to transform us into his likeness, the image of a rebel. Because he rebelled from God, and he wants to take everyone he can down with him. That's his goal. And that's why it's so important to remain vigilant and to look at what the truth is. Are these things that we're watching and doing whispering lies to us? Or are they actually rooted in the truth? Are they showing what virtue is and what we should be striving towards? Are they calling us to conversion? Are they calling us back to God? Back to our source, back to the source of all goodness and whose image we're made from. And God wants to transform us into his likeness. He wants us to share in his life, in his blessed life forever in heaven. That's the goal. That's why it's so important to remain vigilant and to remember who we are and to be careful and watch what we're consuming. And so I want to invite everyone here to really think about, what do I watch that could poison my soul? What do I watch that could poison my soul? And also, am I living in such a way as to actually let God's word grow within me? Am I living in such a way as to actually let God's word grow in me? It's so important to root out the vices, to strive to be like God, to become a saint. Because as a very, very good man once said, the only real sadness, the only real failure, the only great tragedy is not to become a saint.
I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father, through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. We now turn to God with our prayers.
That our Bishop Charles may follow God's will and seek the good of those he serves, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those entrusted with dispensing justice and interpreting the law may look to Christ as the source of wisdom, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may await for God's harvest time and not pass harsh judgment on others, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the aged in our community may be sustained by our thoughtfulness and friendship, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who have died may be gathered into the harvest of the kingdom, especially for Richard Lux. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. And we pray also for Warren Browning, who went home to God last night, and for Ron, his son, and for all of his family as they grieve. We pray to the Lord. Almighty God, we bring to you these and all our prayers. In your love, we ask you to answer us through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Our offertory song this morning is number 395 in the music issue, Here I Am, Lord.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours will be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
O God, who in the one perfect sacrifice brought to completion varied offerings of the law, accept, we pray, the sacrifice from your faithful servants and make it holy, as you bless the gifts of Abel, so that what each has offered to the honor of your majesty may benefit the salvation of all. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you laid the foundations of the world and have arranged the changing of times and seasons. You formed man in your own image and set humanity over the whole world in all its wonder. To rule in your name over all you have made, and forever praise your mighty works through Christ our Lord. And so with the angels we praise you, and as in joyful celebration we acclaim. Created rightly gives you praise, for through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and to make them holy, and you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim, by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, Grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint Vincent de Paul, Saint Bridget of Sweden, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession and your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Charles, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you in your compassion, O merciful Father. Gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, unto all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory. Through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you always.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Christ. The blood of Christ. Body of Christ. The body of Christ. The body of Christ. Amen. The blood of Christ. Body of Christ.
Amen.
Body of Christ. Amen. The body of Christ. The body of Christ. Amen. The body of Christ. The body of Christ. May God bless you. The body of Christ. 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 May God bless you, wife. The body of Christ. 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 May God bless you all. The body of Christ. Body of Christ. The body of Christ. The body of Christ. The body of Christ. May God bless you. May God, body of Christ.
Like a shepherd, he feeds his flocks and gathers
the body of Christ.
The lambs in his arms.
The body of Christ.
Holding them carefully
close the body of
to his heart.
The body of Christ.
Leading them home.
The body of Christ.
I myself
the body of Christ.
Will shepherd them.
The body of Christ.
For others have led
the body of
Christ.
May God bless you.
I will rescue
the body of
and
Christ.
Heal their wounds.
The body
and
of Christ.
To them, giving them
the body of Christ. The body of Christ.
Like a shepherd, he feeds
the body of Christ.
His flock and gathers
the body
the lambs in his arms.
The body of Christ.
Holding them carefully.
May God bless you.
Heart,
may God bless you.
Leading
the body of Christ. The body of Christ. The body of Christ. God bless you. Body of Christ. The body of Christ.
Amen.
The body. May God bless you always. Body of Christ. The body of Christ.
Sure.
Let us pray. Graciously be present to your people, we pray, O Lord, and lead those you have imbued with heavenly mysteries to pass from former ways to newness of life, through Christ our Lord. Blessings to everyone. Be sure to grab a bulletin on the way out. There are many announcements. We have a trip to Kings Island for high schoolers on the 2nd of August. We've got the Joint Parish Picnic coming up on August 9th and many other things. And so be sure to grab a bulletin on your way out. And have a beautiful Lord's Day. The Lord be with you.
And your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Go forth, the Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God.
Our closing song is number 739 in your music issue, Lead Me, Lord.
shall be theirs. Blessed are the sorrowing, for they shall be consoled. And the meek shall come to rule the world. Lead me, Lord, lead me, Lord, by the light of truth, to seek and to find the narrow way. Be my way, be my truth, be my life, my Lord, and lead me home.